Terima kasih banyak. Sudi bersama kami dalam Selamat Pagi Malaysia. Kita lagi setengah jam. Setengah jam nak habis. Kita ada tetamu istimewa, Redwin.
Ya, ini berkenaan dengan bola sepak. Okay. Yang mana juga kita berikan semangat dan juga sokongan pada masa sama untuk skuad ataupun kontingen yang beraksi di Filipina. Kita nak bersama dengan Wan Kuzain, Wan Kamal.
Mana dia pembina Wan Kuzain?
Ramai yang kenal. Bukan sahaja di Malaysia, bahkan di luar negara. Dan juga kita ada Ahmad Muzamil Muhammad Hari, Ketua Editor Semuanya Bola. How are you?
Good. Thanks for having me.
So, you're back in KL or in Malaysia since last week?
From 3 weeks ago.
Three weeks ago. Dah lama.
Sebenarnya kalau cakap bahasa Melayu pun dia faham. Sikit-sikit boleh lah. Ayah dia orang Kelantan. Boleh kecek Kelantan tau. Tak faham langsung. Okay. Tak apa, sikit-sikit. Nanti kahwin dengan orang Malaysia, nanti boleh cakap Melayu lah.
Okay, baik. Sebelum tu kita nak pergi ke mungkin yang belum mengenali Kuzain ni, yalah, macam saya kata tadi, ayahnya orang Kelantan, mak orang KL, tapi dilahirkan di US kerana ayah bekerja di United States. Jadi itu sebabnya juga kita diberikan peluang untuk bersama dengan Wan Kuzain kerana dia juga mempunyai klub bola sepak di sana. You have your own football club, or are you part of the team?
Yeah, so currently right now I play for Sporting Kansas City in the MLS, Major League Soccer. It's the highest tier of soccer in the U.S. The likes of Zlatan Ibrahimovic, Wayne Rooney, Luis Nani, just to name a few, playing that league, yeah.
Kuzain, you're still young. Is it football your full-time career or?
Yes, football is my full-time job.
Yeah.
Still young, but wouldn't want to have it any other way. Living the dream.
Okay, kita nak tanya banyak benda lagi. Sahabat kita, Ahmad Muzamil sendirilah. Kita tengok prestasi Harimau Malaya di Sukan C. Agak banyak juga kritikan. Macam mana anda sendiri melihatnya?
Ya, kalau kita tengok kat social media sekarang ni, ramai yang pesalahkan formasi yang diterapkan oleh Coach Ong Kim Swee. 3-4-3 tak sesuai lah, banyak main long ball lah. Kemudian kalau kita tanya pelis, dia orang kata skuad ni adalah pemain yang bersatu. Tak ada apa-apa perpecahan, pergaduhan dan sebagainya. Jadi bila Piaukong memerhatikan keputusan yang agak teruk di Sukan C ni, Piaukong cuba nak cari satu titik yang dia boleh pinpoint apa kesilapan kita. So benda ni yang masih lagi dicari-cari, adakah masalah padang ke? Padang pun konklusi kata bukan, dan masa camp training sebelum terbang ke Filipina itu pun budak-budak Malaysia ni dah train dekat arena NPSJ, which is artificial turf. So benda ni membuatkan ramai orang tertanya-tanya apa sebenarnya yang berlaku sehingga membuatkan persembahan pasukan negara ini agak kurang menyelah. Tapi satu perkara yang positif tentang kekalahan ini adalah yang membuatkan kita fikir bahawa sebenarnya kita masih lagi belum jauh ketinggalan, belum jauh meninggalkan negara-negara lain di Asia Tenggara ni. Kita sangka kita dah kalahkan Thailand dan Indonesia di sini. Kita dah jauh dah.
Okay, Wan Kuzain, for sure you're following the updates about the local team in Sukan C. Maybe from your observations, what you can share about us?
Well, actually, you should be in team, right?
I mean, for when I was with the team, everything was good. Everything was professional. Dr. Ong Kim Swee and the staff really took care of the players, and that's one thing you really notice when I first got there. Everything from the hotel to how the training staff interacted with the players to how training was set up, everything was how I was used to in the U.S. Obviously, this was kind of my first foray into Malaysian football, and I never really knew how, you know, it worked, and I was interested to see how it worked, and everything I was in during the camp had surpassed my expectations. Everything was how I was used to in the U.S., so from that standpoint, Dr. Ong Kim Swee and the staff made everything look very easy and transitionless for me. Speaking, you know, about the players and how they performed in the SEA Games, I mean, yeah, social media is saying one thing, but, you know, it's easier said than done.
Yeah.
Football is a sport, like any sport, that you never know what happens. That's why we love sports, right? Because the underdog can always win. It's not always the top dog that's always going to win. And at the end of the day, it just wasn't their luck. But the future is very bright for Malaysian football, I will say that.
Baik, Muzamil, sekiranya Wan Kuzen ada menyertai tim Malaysia pada waktu itu, adakah harapan
akan ada impak ke dalam tim kalau Wan Kuzen berada dalam tim itu?
Ya, saya boleh kata ada impak besar sebab kalau kita tengok satu kita punya kegagalan masa persembahan sukan situ adalah megang penguasaan bola. Dan satu benda yang saya tahu pasal Wan Kuzen adalah cara permainan dia adalah penguasaan bola. Dia tak suka hantar bola melulu-lulu. He always thinks before he make a pass. So maybe dengan adanya kualiti Wan Kuzen di bahagian tengah tu boleh membantu skuad negara, tapi ini ada persoalan if, persoalan
kalau.
So lagi elok sebenarnya kalau benda ni jadi realiti kan, tapi apakan daya.
Tapi mungkin juga mungkin Safawi Rasid tidak bersama dalam skuad kebangsaan, ramai juga inilah tak pilih Safawi Rasid. Dia sepatutnya boleh menyumbang kepada tim.
Ya, betul. Tapi kita perlu tengok Safawi dah bermain lebih daripada 50 perlawanan pada tahun ni.
National lah kan?
Ya. Kalau kita tengok apa yang terjadi pada bintang Vietnam, Nguyen Co Hai, yang bermain sehingga 55 perlawanan, sehingga menyebabkan beliau cedera baru-baru ni ketika bermain di Sukan C.
Betul. Yeah, yeah. You know Safawi Rasid, right?
Yeah, I know.
Actually, we have a lot of quality player in Malaysia.
Yeah, no doubt. like I kind of said, touched on, Malaysia, the future is very bright. You can see from past results that the youth national team, they've gotten good results against good teams, against, you know, in good quality tournaments. I think what it was, the under-19s won this previous tournament. I don't remember the tournament, but I think they're also heading into their World Cup campaign, and honestly I think that team is very good, so we should be expecting a lot. But it's, at the end of the day, it's up to them. So youth football is always different. It's up to their development to see if one day they can reach the senior team.
Okay. Baik, kita nak tanya juga Wan Kuzin, memandangkan dia dah mungkin dah lama tak balik Malaysia. Kita tanyalah, for how long you're not being in Malaysia? For almost 8?
Maybe
10 years?
More than that.
Maybe more than that, yeah.
Okay.
Let's say 15 years.
15 years. Okay. The first time you land in Malaysia, what the first thing you want to like, you want to eat or want to do in Malaysia?
What's special Malaysia?
I think the first thing I ended up eating was nasi lemak.
Nasi lemak, of course.
Which is of course, yeah.
The nasi kerabu from Kelantan?
I have had it. It wasn't one of the first things I had.
Darah Kelantan, eh?
It's some budu with it.
Budu, yes. Okay.
But no, I think the first thing I did end up doing was visit the Petronas Towers. I think that's a must do from anyone who hasn't been to KL. But before I got to Malaysia, I was obviously well versed, both my parents being Malay. My dad's also a very good cook, so I'm very familiar with all the Malay foods. He makes really good ayam percut. I think I wanted to find that one of my first weeks in Malaysia. Yeah.
Okay, bye. Sahabat kita, kita tengok selepas sukan C lah sebagai contohnya. Mungkin bagaimana kita nak melihat kepada prestasi pelapis-pelapis ini untuk masa depan Malaysia, sebab kita ada banyak lagi pelawanan-pelawanan besar selepas ini.
Satu benda yang kita perlu buat adalah kita perlu memperkencangkan usaha kita di peringkat
akaun.
Ya, kita kena, orang kata, letak lebih banyak bajet. Macam baru-baru ini apabila belanjawan 2020 diumumkan, 45 juta diperuntukkan, peningkatan daripada 15 juta. Ia adalah satu berita gembira sebenarnya bagi Bola Sepak Negara, sebab 45 juta ni boleh buat macam-macam benda untuk NFDP. Kemudian pada masa sama ada juga berita optimistik daripada FM yang mengatakan akan adanya satu liga untuk sekolah-sekolah. Liga-liga untuk bawah 18, bawah 16, bawah 12, di mana liga ni akan mengumpulkan sekolah-sekolah ni. Jadi apabila sekolah-sekolah ni dah dikumpul dalam satu liga bertanding, maknanya budak-budak ni ada 30 perlawanan kompetitif setiap tahun, dan ini yang membuatkan pemain-pemain ni dia jadi berkembang lah bakatnya berbanding sekarang ni masuk majlis sukan-sukan daerah, sukan-sukan negeri, majlis sukan-sukan Malaysia. Tapi total perlawanan masih lagi kurang 30. Jadi ini sebenarnya satu peningkatan dan penambahbaikan yang cukup bagus lah.
Okay, mungkin juga peluang yang ada pada waktu ini Wan Kuzin berada di Malaysia, difahamkan juga Wan Kuzin ada bersama dengan tim-tim sekolah lain untuk melakukan training, mengambil kesempatan juga. So maybe in future you can lead the under 19 and under 21 team.
Maybe.
Ya, itu antara kepakaran yang beliau bawa dari US kan, sebagai mereka juga yang mempunyai position yang major dalam sukan bola sepak di sana. Apapun, terima kasih kita ucapkan dan thank you so much Wan Kuzin.
Thank you for having me.
Maybe last. Yeah. For your fan in Malaysia, something you want to say?
Thanks.
You got a lot of fans in Malaysia.
Yeah, for sure. And I appreciate it. Thank you to all, you know, Malaysian fans, Malaysian football fans, and just everyone in general who's been just so nice ever since I've touched down in Malaysia. Every time I visit, I feel the love, I feel welcomed. Anytime I'm walking somewhere, I'm getting pictures and stuff like that, and you can never take stuff for granted, because at the end of the day, that's the reason why you play, for people like that, for the country that supports you. So love that. Yeah, absolutely love it.
But one day you want to be in national team. Listen.
Hopefully one day. Hopefully, like I said, both countries, obviously the U.S. means a lot as well. Yeah. Malaysia means a lot as well. One country isn't higher than the other. Yeah. And at the end of the day, when the decision comes, it won't be a decision that's taken lightly. It'll be a decision that comes with a lot of thought, talking to friends, family, and wherever I end up one day is a decision I will have to live with.
Terima kasih banyak Wan Kuzin. Kita harapkan anda akan menjadi salah seorang pemain Barisan Harapan Malaysia. Thank you so much.
Terima kasih banyak.
Bila pulang ke US?
Next week.
Dia faham macam sebelah ini. Muzamil, terima kasih banyak sebelum kami ringkas, tapi saya rasa amat bermakna buat peminat-peminat bola sepak sekalian. Okey, kita nak tengok satu bingkisan lagi.
Bingkisan